ShoeGame TV, and I'm here at SneakerCon LA with the talented Wale, and we have Patrick here too with Villa. Wale, tell me what's going on with Bottle Rocket.
Man, we're doing Michael Jordan numbers.
Oh, really?
They say.
I heard.
I'm just excited that my first, you know, venture in the sneaker world, my first true venture in the sneaker world was received so well. You know, it's a humbling experience, even
right.
for people to be like surrounding me, like I'm like Tinker Hatfield or something right now. I feel like, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But it's the beginning of a great relationship between myself and people.
Right now, how did this collaboration come spawn?
Now,
really?
We'd be stupid not to do it.
Right.
It was natural. But the cool thing is, we first sat down with Wale. He said, I've been a part of this game all this time. It's time for me to start curating. It's time for me to start creating stories, not just wearing them. And this is the first one of Bottle Rocket. Success.
It's amazing. Success. I mean, they're beautiful. I heard they're already sold out. I mean, I can wear them 4th of July, too, right around the corner. How did this love for shoes come in your life? When did you start loving?
When I grew up, like growing up, we didn't have no money. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like shoes wasn't like a common thing. So maybe about 6th grade, I realized the importance of like, you're going to need, you're going to have to figure it out some kind of way. So every situation, my mother gave us $100 each for back to school shopping. And I spent like 75 on sneakers.
Did you really?
And then, you know what I'm saying? And then from then on, man, like, I was white tees, was all Hanes, white tees.
But you had the hottest kicks on your feet, right?
Pretty good shoes at that point.
That's nice. So your love started at what age, would you say?
I'm probably about 10 years old, 11.
Do you remember your first pair of sneakers you bought?
That I bought?
Yeah.
With my own money?
Uh-huh.
Flight Posit ones, probably.
Really?
I think some Garnets or something like that.
That's crazy. So the love for the sneakers, and now you're curating. How does that feel?
I mean, It's a natural progression in my career that I always wanted to do. Like, you know, when you become famous, you know, I encourage anybody who did that to focus on what they like to do.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, any day now, you might not love what you love as much anymore. So
right.
Try to develop other crafts and other hobbies and stuff like that.
Right, and it's a blessing. I mean, you're doing everything that you love, right? How did Asics come?
Well, I already liked what they were doing with the gel lights. I already liked what they were doing. And, you know, obviously, I've always been a big Nike fan, but at some point you gotta be like, you know, you're worth it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And Ruth Villa, like, they're such a forward-thinking brand. They kind of like gave me a lot of freedom to do
right.
a lot of what I want to do, from a community aspect to a creative aspect to, you know, collaborating with other creative people that I'm cool with. So it was kind of a natural thing, man. The people at Ruth Villa are real good to me, so
that's amazing.
They allow me to like. An artist,
right?
And then go to the meetings, but I'm still in artist mode. Like you know, we just work well together.
Right. So you're exclusively a part of every piece of the shoe.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Are you surprised at all the success on this first one? Surprised?
Yeah. No, not really, but I mean, but you know, we're gonna do some out crazy, like far out shoes. We went real vanilla first go around.
Can you give us a hint of a little bit of what's next? Still in the first one. All right, perfect.
The releases, the rollout is everything.
Okay, well, we'll be waiting.
We like the element of surprise.
All right, well, we're here with Wale. Bottle Rocket's out. Thank you so much, guys, for being here with us at SneakerCon LA, ShoeGame TV. Yeah. Somebody tell him that I'm back.